Hi everyone, I'm Pavel. So I invested in two real estate units. First time when I was 26 and the second time when I was 28. And I did that from scratch, without using my own money, and I didn't know anything about real estate investment beforehand. And once I did that, several people from my family and friends got intrigued and asked me for advice. So, long story short, now each single one of them has bought their first unit and they're looking to buy more. So I'll give you some tips in this video how you can also get started. First of all, you should know that this is not a get rich quick scheme, but more like a get independent over time scheme. With these two units that I have, they already generate money for me because I'm renting them out on Airbnb. So basically, I get around $800 extra cash per month. So not only is real estate an extremely interesting investment option, but now it became even more profitable thanks to the growth of Airbnb. And when I'll be 45, I will be able to retire with just these two units. Because instead of $800 per month, they will generate about $1,500 for me because my mortgage will be paid off by that time. But obviously, I don't count on stopping here. I will buy more units, but I just want to put that in contrast with some other gurus or experts that you find on YouTube and elsewhere, which pretend to explain you how you can suddenly borrow millions of dollars, buy dozens of units in a few years, and get rich and financially independent within 3 to 5 years from now. So, nope. My approach is more realistic than that. I know it is because I did it, and I also know how complicated it all seems when you haven't ever invested in anything in your life. So I don't want to set unrealistic expectations for you, right? What I want is that most of you who watch this video, no matter your situation, no matter where you live in the world, that you feel like you can achieve your first real estate investment and that sometime later you actually do it. After that, you will be able to move on by yourself with more investment units once you understand the process, because you'll just need to repeat it. And now you're maybe wondering, why then most people don't buy real estate? Well, that's because it's a mindset problem. It's because society doesn't explain us how to do it. Instead, it teaches us to get a job, a salary, work 5 days a week for most of the weeks in the year, and that until retirement. And while we do that, we're supposed to pay rent. And maybe, just maybe, some people will eventually decide to get a mortgage to pay off their main property where they live. But that's it for most. That's where most of the people stop at. And yet, even this is changing when you read articles that say millennials don't want to buy a home anymore. They prefer to rent, live a lean lifestyle, being digital nomads and blah blah blah. Well, but this is actually extremely good for people like you and me who understand that being an owner is extremely important. And so that's where there are investors, those who own real estate and rent it to other people. So let me reveal one of the main secrets of our societies today. If you look at data about your own city or any other big city in the world, chances are that the majority of people who live in that city don't own the property that they live in. They pay rent. So, what does it mean, right? It means that they are making the owners, so the investors, rich. Either they generate their passive income or they pay off their mortgage and still make them rich in the process. So obviously what you should aim for is to become an owner of such a property that you rent to other people. And today, thanks to the growth of Airbnb, you can generate much more money with it and it becomes even more profitable. So now you're probably wondering, how do I buy my first property if I don't have money? Well, here's another secret of many investors. Very often they don't use their own money to buy this kind of stuff. So when it comes to real estate, most people get a mortgage, a loan from a bank. And to get this loan, it depends on many criteria, but honestly, most of the people can't fulfill them. First of all, banks love long-term job contracts. So if you have such a contract, you should know that you are the preferred type of borrower for the bank. It is much more difficult for independent people like freelancers, new business owners, or those with fixed-term job contracts, etc., to get loans than it is for those who have regular long-term job contracts. And so if you have such a contract, then you should know that you can have a monthly debt of about 30 to 40% of your disposable income, depending on the country where you live. So for example, let's say that your salary is $2,000 net. And you pay a rent of $500 per month. You have no kids and no other loans. Then your disposable income is of $1,500. So you can pay a monthly loan of up to 30% of that which is $500. And if we just make a very quick estimation with an interest rate of 3% and a 20-year long term without all the other fees for now, just to make it simple, that would allow you to purchase a property that costs $90,000. So if there's anything that costs this much in your city, you can buy it without any problem. However, the question is, what about the down payment, right? Well, in many European countries, you can totally take loans without using any of your own money upfront. So you can take 100% loans and even 110% loans, where the bank also pays you the real estate agency and the notary fees. But it's much more complicated in the United States, for example. Most of the American banks require rather big down payments and also all the other requirements to get a mortgage, such as the job contract duration and income statements in the US are much harsher than in many European countries. So it makes things much more complicated for Americans than it is for most Europeans. But if you're American, it doesn't mean that you have to give up. You can still find ways to navigate this complex legal landscape. The point is that it really depends on the country where you live, and there are many countries in the world which have really great and realistic opportunities to start investing in real estate without using your own money upfront. So now let's get back to our $90,000 property in such a country that does provide favorable mortgage conditions. So then of course the question is, how much income a unit that costs this much in your city can generate, right? Both on Airbnb and with the long-term tenant. And from here, you can calculate your gross revenue per year and see if it covers your mortgage and all the other expenses. In my case, it does. Like I said, it doesn't just pay off my loan and build my capital, but it also generates extra income for me. So this was just a very quick, very basic presentation of how these things generally work and what you can and cannot do. But of course, there are many, many other things to consider when buying a property for vacation rentals to make it the most profitable for you. Like what kind of units to look for, where should they be located, how to uncover the best deals, what are the tricks to buy properties that are more expensive than those that you can afford with a monthly loan of 30% of your disposable income, etc, etc. And myself, I was actually surprised to realize how relatively easy it is to start investing. And by easy, I mean realistic, right? Because most people don't even think that they can do it. So I put all my knowledge and experience about this topic in an online course that you find by following the link in the description. And inside this course, I explain all the steps that you should take in order to achieve your first real estate investment. And these steps are very, very practical. I'm convinced that if you take this course and if you do follow the steps that I explain inside, you will become an owner of a real estate unit relatively soon. That will take you a few months, a year or two, but honestly, within a time frame of 1 year, it is realistic. And also, if you click on that link, you will be able to see some of the videos for free as previews, which also contain interesting information for you. And then you can decide for yourself if you want to learn more about this topic to become a real estate investor. So check it out and hopefully see you inside. And while you're here, don't forget to subscribe to my YouTube channel. When I will make new investments, when I will learn new stuff, I will share it here with you.